हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ़ यू इन अवर यूट्यूब चैनल नॉलेज कैप्चर। एज वी ऑल नो, होल वर्ल्ड इज़ फेसिंग द कोरोना आउटब्रेक्स एंड इन दिस आउटब्रेक्स इकोनॉमिक स्लो डाउन हैपन इन ऑल द कंट्रीज। एज लाइक दैट अवर इंडिया ऑल्सो फेसिंग द इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस ड्यू टू कोरोना आउटब्रेक्स। अवर गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग मैनी स्टेप्स टू काउंटर दैट एंड इन दिस टाइम तेलंगाना CM के चंद्रशेखर राव एडवाइजेड टू RBI टू इम्प्लीमेंट हेलीकॉप्टर मनी एंड दिस इज मेकिंग न्यूज रिसेंटली। So today we will discuss about this. Helicopter money doesn't mean gives money from the helicopter, but it means it is a tool of monetary policy which is made by the Reserve Bank of India, and this is not widely used tool. Helicopter money increases the supply of money in the market to meet that goal. Government thus prints money in the more quantity to distribute money in the people and thus boost up the economy. So the helicopter money word was used for the first time by the American economist Milton Friedman in 1960. Why it is in news? So recently Telangana CM K Chandrasekhar Rao advised to Reserve Bank of India to implement helicopter money to counter economic crisis, as earlier we talked about this. So how can we do this helicopter money? Helicopter money means giving cash to the people by printing money in the large quantity, and in the era of digitalization, transferring money in the bank accounts of people. Why is it different than others' monetary policy? Government gives cash to the people which they did not need to return back in future. For example, when we take loan from the bank, we need to clear our loan within due date, adding interest rate. But in this case, the scene is different, as we are not returning money. In the same situation, like government is also not returning money to the RBI. Which are the objectives of helicopter money? Government gives cash to the people and they are buying the goods and services, and that leads to increasing the demands of goods and services, and that increase the GDP, gross domestic products of the country, and boosting the economic growth. But this money should be used only in goods and services rather than depositing in saving accounts. If people will deposit that money in saving accounts, they will not buy goods and services, and doesn't increases the demand and GDP, will not fulfill the objective of helicopter money. When government implementing this helicopter money policy? So helicopter money will be implemented only in the situation where no any plans of monetary policy doesn't boosting the GDP, and that time government implementing this. But in our India, we can boost economy by making changes in the monetary policy. So this is the least usable idea. Which are the negative impacts of helicopter money? When increasing the supply of money in the market, that increasing the demands, and that leads to the inflation. For example, we are selling 50 things and there are the 100 people who want to buy that thing. So increasing the demand and inflation rates. Other negative impact of helicopter money is the devaluation of rupee. When increasing the supply of money in the market, decreasing the value of that money. That's why happened the devaluation of the rupee. Other negative impact is people using that money in the saving accounts rather than buying goods and services, and that doesn't complete the main objective of economic growth. So this is the all about helicopter money. We have discussed all the aspects of helicopter money. Thank you. If you like this video, share it and subscribe the channel Knowledge Capture, and press bell icon to get notifications of all the videos.